Number three, human by nature, he wants to have some control. Mm-hmm. Yes? A human by nature, he wants to be a brave one. Mm-hmm. Bravely. Got it? Mm-hmm. And human by nature, he wants to have noble character. Noble character like hospitality. Okay. To be a decent person. Yes? Mm-hmm. To be a cooperative one. Okay. Helping the poor. If somebody challenge his manhood, then he will retaliate.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That is the actual thing. Mm-hmm. If his manhood is challenged, and it differ from area to area, mm-hmm. that what it means, manhood. For example, look, my traditions mm-hmm. and my culture, to be committed to, we call it manhood. So if somebody will challenge it, so they retaliate.
Okay.
To defend their culture, to defend their tradition. Got it? Same is the case of faith and belief. Mm-hmm. If somebody is challenging the faith and belief, so then they are trying and striving hard to defend it.
Right.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. As far as the propaganda is concerned, propaganda means that manhood to Pashtun means to control women just like slaves. That is totally wrong.
Okay.
That is the wrong propaganda.
Mm-hmm.
We the Pashtun, yes, for the protection of the chastity of woman, maybe she is not related to us. Mm-hmm. Sometimes Pashtun go to their extent. That why a villain or wicked person, yes, mm-hmm. looked malefiedly at a woman. Because woman is much more respected in Pashtun culture.
Okay.
And when I say woman, my friend, when I say woman, I don't mean my own mother, my own sister, my own daughter, or my own wife. No, I say woman in general.
Okay.
Anybody it can be. So in Pashtun area, if somebody will come to know that that guy, he is looking at that woman with malefied intention. Yes. So any Pashtun, he approaches him there. I notice you. You are staring at that woman. So the first ever thing, we challenge his nature.
Okay.
Yes. So what we say? We say, you don't have mother. You don't have wife. You don't have daughter and sister. If somebody else will look at your mother with such intention, what do you think about that? So actually that is in his nature. Yes. So he will feel ashamed of what he has done. And he will say, sorry, forgive me. And if he will not say it, so the first ever thing, look my friend, that will be a slap on his face.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Okay.
Yes. So you like this culture or not?
Yes, it's
you like
very
it.
Interesting.
Yes. That is. Anything else if you want?
Okay. I wrote a few questions.
Go ahead.
So let me look at different ones here.
Yes.
Okay.
Just take your time.
While I was reading, I came up to the words Nang and Namus.
Yes. Yes. Nang and Namus, that's what I told you. Ego and self respect.
Okay.
Yes. That is Nang and Namus.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
In our specific word for Nangu Namus, we call it Ghera. G-H-E-E-R-A-T. Gherat.
Gherat.
G-H-E-E-R-A-T. Gherat.
Okay.
Yes, I do admit that some of us, because every tribe and every nation has good and bad people. Mm-hmm. You know that.
Yes.
Yes. That's common in human being.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So somebody, we do use that Nangu Namus and Ghera in a wrong way also, which is not good. Yes. And the elites or the talented people, later on they blame that what he has done, that is wrong. That is not Ghera. He crossed over the border.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So actually, that is a mistake in application. Itself, that term is good. Itself, that term is good. Terminology is good. But sometimes we do a mistake in its application. Right. Application is wrong. Got it?
Got it. Let me see here. Okay. What are some specific things, for example, when do you notice that a boy is becoming a man?
Actually, that is not Pashtun culture.
Okay.
In this regard, we do follow Islamic culture.
Okay.
Yes?
Okay.
Or Islamic rules. So in Islam, when a boy intends towards a girl, he has an intention towards a girl.
Okay.
Or he saw a wet sexual dream. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So we say that now he's a baligh, or he's an adult.
So what's the word?
Baligh. B-A-L-I-G-H.
B-A-L.
B-L.
B-A-L.
B-A-L.
I-G-H.
I-G-H.
Baligh.
Yes. In English you can call attained the age of puberty.
Okay.
Yes. Attained the age of puberty.
Okay.
Yes. Now you got it?
Mm-hmm.
And for a girl, when her menses starts, so she is a baligh.
Okay.
Her menstruation started, so it means that she is a baligh.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
But for the said purpose, in boy, the minimum age is 12 years. The minimum age is 12 years. But in girl, that is 9 years.
Okay.
That is not the age of puberty.
Mm-hmm.
That is the age for that symbol. So if the symbol appears before 12 years of age in a boy, you can write it like this.
Mm-hmm.
If the symbol of wet dream, it was seen in a boy when he was less than 12 years of age, we don't say that he has attained the age of puberty. We say that sickness.
Okay.
What is that? And same is the case of menses. If blood started for a girl in less than 9 years of age, we say that sickness.
Illness is interesting.
Yes, or illness. That's a disease.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But if these symbols are not seen there in a boy and girl, then age-wise, we do have the same concept as America.
Okay.
Because most of us, we are following Hanafi school of jurisprudence.
Okay.
Hanafi, H-A-N-A-F-I. Hanafi school of jurisprudence. So age-wise, Hanafi school of jurisprudence decrees a boy and a girl, or decide a boy and a girl as baligh or adult when he or she is 18 years of age.
Okay.
Now you got it?
Yes.
There are other schools of jurisprudence. They say 17, 16 and 15.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Just go ahead.
Okay. I don't want
to... No.
Just go ahead. This is also a part of our job.
Okay.
That's a part of our business. We are here, yes, what we can say? To tell friends like you that we Pashtuns, Muslims in general and Pashtuns special, are in specific. We are not human beings from a different planet.
Right.
We are from the same planet.
Mm-hmm.
We are human beings. We are the offspring and children of Adam and Eve, like other people are. Yes, but people are thinking of us other way around.
Right.
That they are very cruel people and very brutal people and they don't know anything but only killing. And yes, people think about us that we are blood monger or something like that, which
right.
is totally wrong.
Mm-hmm.
If you will go to Pashtun area and look, they will come to know that this friend of ours, he is a stranger. He is from America. He is not a Muslim. Yes, they will give you much more respect than any other guest. That he is a guest. Yeah, hospitality.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. No, that will be more than hospitality. Because they will try to put in your mind that what the propaganda is, that's totally wrong.
Right.
So you should observe yourself that what's going on here. Once I was here in a store, an old guy in late 60s or early 70s, when he saw my turban and this dress of mine, so he came to me. And he said, the Islamic greeting, Salaamu Alaikum, peace be upon you. I said, Wa Alaikum, and upon you as well. Got it?
Yes.
So then he said that you are from Afghanistan or from northern Pakistan. I said that My great-great-grandfathers are my ancestors. They were from Afghanistan. But now we are living administrative-wise in Pakistani part of Pashtun.
Okay.
So he said, oh, I visited that part of Pakistan, the Pashtun area.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I love the people there. I said, right. My friend, why? He said, oh, the way they hospitalize, even though they do not know. And hospitalized doesn't mean that they will roast a lamb or because they are poor people.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but they will do as much as they can do.
Mm-hmm.
He said that once I was there in a small village and a shepherd was there. You know shepherd, the herdsman.
Yes.
Yes, with his goats and lambs and things like that. Yes, and I greeted him and he welcomed me and he shook hand with me and he was looking at my face. So he came to know that he's a stranger and from outside. So he had his food with him,
mm-hmm.
yes, in that desert. And he opened it, and he said that, can you please, yes, mm-hmm. and I will milk a goat for you.
Hmm.
Yes, and he said that I enjoyed that milk, because that was fresh
right.
milk, and he brought it to me. He said that that's whatever I have,
mm-hmm.
this dry bread and this milk.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Got it.
And he said that one guy, he was having, we have a specific type of hat,
mm-hmm.
Yes, on our head, especially in winter. That is made of wood. That is handmade. Made of wood. We use that.
Mm-hmm.
He said that, I said to the shepherd, that your hat is very beautiful. He said that, oh, then I was saying, I didn't say for this head purpose. He said, no, no, I have a few of them. That's for you.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Okay.
Just go ahead.
One last question. About the beard and the turban.
Yes,
when
this is
let
actually
the beard grow.
Yes, actually beard and turban, that is human nature.
Okay.
Or human practice. That okay. is not only Pashtun practice or Muslim practice. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
In old pictures or images of Jesus,
mm-hmm.
you can see the same type of turban on his head as well.
His beard.
You know what I'm saying? And you can see his beard as well.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You can see the same thing for Moses.
Yes.
You have seen the movies, so you cannot find out Moses without beard.
Right.
Or without turban. Or mm-hmm. without this type of dress.
Abraham.
So it means that this is human culture.
Yes.
Basically. And to tell you one thing, that turban is a protection of your head, number one. That's a dignity, number two. And that's a qualification as well.
Okay.
How? Still, when anybody is graduated in an Islamic school or Islamic university, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So what we do? We give him a degree,
mm-hmm.
certificate or degree,
okay.
and we put a turban on his head.
Okay.
And the same practice is known all over the world. The okay. Jew used to do that in graduation. The Christians used to do that mm-hmm. in graduation. But now look, to tie yes. this on your own head, that's actually an experience. And to tie it
right.
on the head of somebody else, that is more than experience. You know what I'm
right.
saying? Very
yes.
difficult to tie it on the head of another body.
Mm-hmm.
So now what they did, still, when somebody is graduating or students are graduating, though they are putting a hat on their head,
mm-hmm.
a gown and a hat, and
yes.
they said it
tassel.
Has a tassel. So
mm-hmm.
actually, that hat represents the turban.
Okay. Is there a certain age or something when the man starts
actually
to grow beard?
Islamically, when the beard comes, that is not allowed in Islam to be shaved.
Okay.
Yes. Leave it as it is, natural.
Okay.
And we Pashtuns are a little bit more committed to Islam, so that's why. Most of us, we have the beard and we have the turban.
Okay.
Turban is our Islamic culture and Pashtun cultures as well.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Still, if you will visit our area, and especially the villages,
mm-hmm.
not the modern part, the cities,
right.
the villages, the countryside, so you will find all people, they have this beard and they have the turbans.
Okay.
It doesn't mean that they are scholars of religion. No, they are common lay people. But
mm-hmm.
this is a part of our culture.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, this has been very helpful. I...
yes, this is good.
It's just... I really feel like I'm bothering you guys.
No, 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 we are
not.
You are not. Feel free. Look, that what I told a few time or every time I do say the same thing to students who are coming from CSUN, from Pepperdine University, from Pierce College, from Mission College, from any other institute, they come here. So after my lecture, I tell them that visit us as frequent as you can, because we are not asking anybody, do you have membership here?